kalau Engkau hadir
di tengah-tengah. Engkau Tuhan pengasih, penyayang dan
Engkau ada di depan.
Murah hati Tuhan, yang sabar Tuhan,
maka hatiku hancur.
Kasihanilahku, tolonglah aku, kasihanilahku. Ampunilah,
aku berseru padamu, ampunilah dosaku
Tuhan.
Ya Tuhan,
ampuni salahku Tuhan.
Aku tidak dapat membayar hutang dosaku.
Sembuhkanlah aku.
Akuilah Tuhan, saudaraku, bahwa Dia adalah penguasa atas hidupmu.
Kami patahkan dan oleh bilur-bilur Yesus menyembuhkan pada malam hari ini.
Haleluya. Stroke 8 tahun disembuhkan oleh Tuhan Yesus.
So when we are afraid, we put our trust in God.
Jesus loves you and He hears you.
Welcome, brothers and sisters. Good day to all of you. It is such a wonderful day.
a fateful day that we can all be here together. From all across the nations in the world, the Lord has chosen this exact time for us to be here together. Brothers and sisters, this is such a joyful day. You might be seeing outside that it is not such a wonderful day in this world right now with everything that's going on. But brothers and sisters, let there be peace in your heart today, for the Lord is here for you today. Brothers and sisters, before we go on, let us all pray together so that the Lord can come and together in this prayer of ours and peace in our heart. Let us all pray. Lord Jesus Christ, I thank you, Lord, for such a wonderful day that I can have here. All I have here together, Lord. Lord, there are only your divine appointments. Lord, you have brought upon us today a lot of people from many, many nations, many tongues, and many tribes. Lord, today I pray, O God, so that you will be Lord and reign over our live streaming today. In the name of Lord Christ, I pray. Amen. Brothers and sisters, how are you all today? Whenever you are, wherever you are right now, in any countries you are right now, any continents, any nations right now, I wish you be welcome, brothers and sisters. Welcome and let the peace of the Lord reign over you right now. Brothers and sisters, we might have seen today, like I have mentioned earlier, if we saw outside of our window, we see a lot of chaos. We see a lot of destructions, we see a lot of lootings, burnings, and a lot of uncertainty. And even as I speak, I'm still at my house right now, and we are still, some of us are still confined to our room. And some of us are still full off from going to work or going to school. But brothers and sisters, today I am going to speak about a good news. A wonderful news, brothers and sisters, a wonderful news that doesn't come from my mouth, doesn't come from my own tongue, but it comes from the Lord. So brothers and sisters, let us dive in. Let us read the Bible today. Brothers and sisters, if you have the Bible today, I ask you to open Psalm 23rd, the first verse until the end. All right, if you don't have any Bible, you can just open a Bible at Google. Google always have there's always a free Bible out there somewhere in any kind of language. So, without further ado, let us open from Psalm, the 23rd, from the first verse. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, said the Bible. Brothers and sisters, this verse said that the Lord is our shepherd. If he is our shepherd, that can only mean that we are his sheep. Brothers and sisters, we are all like a sheep in this world. We are all like a sheep in this world. And if you ever seen a sheep in your life, if you ever go to a ranch or a farm or in the countryside, you might have seen a sheep, a flock of sheep or a goats, and you will see them banding together, and usually there will be a shepherd, one or two, or a couple of shepherds, along with a shepherd dog. And sometimes the shepherd would lead all these lambs, all these sheep. The shepherd would lead the sheep to green pastures. The shepherd would lead the sheep into the stream of water. The shepherd will take control of all the sheep. Brothers and sisters, we are all are likened to a sheep. Even if you are going to say, but I am not a sheep, I am in charge of my own destiny, I'm a master of my own destiny. No, brothers and sisters, none of us are in a charge of our own destiny, and none of us has that amount of power to be in control of our life. Brothers and sisters, we are all are likened to a sheep. We are all just like a sheep. The difference with a sheep is we got to choose who is our shepherd? Either the Lord or the world. Brothers and sisters, for years and years and years, we have chose the world as our shepherd. We have chose the world as our shepherd because why? Because the world as our shepherd is the most real things in our life that we can see, that we can feel. If you're saying, I have no master, I answer to no one. No. You are following something in your life. whether you are following, whether you want to be happy, whether you want to be rich, whether you want to be successful, that is your master. You are following that around. You are pursuing so much. You work so hard towards it. You just labor and labor and labor. You just go from one continent to another continent, talk to so many psychiatrists, taking so many drugs, taking so many recreational drugs maybe, or drinking so many alcoholic drinks, just in order to make you happy. And then you work and you work, you labor, you toil. You wake up early in the morning, you leave your office very late in order to get promotion maybe, in order to perform the best in your office, in order to be the best of the best, in order for your startup to be successful, in order for you to climb the ladder in your office, to be manager and then director, and probably one day you're dreaming of becoming a CEO, or if all the wealth is not your thing, you are looking for happiness here and there. You are going to, you take a plane, you go to Bali, you go to Maldives, you are trying to get happiness, you're going to on top of the Himalaya mountains, and you're trying to find a teacher or somebody, and you are just trying to find happiness in this world, a purpose in this world. You are following everything that you thought would bring you meaning in this life. Brothers and sisters, we are all just like a sheep in this world. We are all just like a sheep in this world. But let me tell you about a shepherd that is different from what we have been following years and years by years. I will talk to you about the Lord who chose to be our shepherd. So let us read again from Psalm 23, the first verse until the fourth. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of the death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Brothers and sisters, we have been following our desires for long. We have been making those desires as our shepherd for years and years and years. But the Lord said, when he is our shepherd, he will make us lie down in green pastures. While our other shepherd that we have been following for years has been enslaving us, has been enslaving us for so long, has made us following and chasing all the dreams of this world, all of our desires, all of our deepest desires, all the things that the world told us would bring us happiness. We have been following our desires for so long, and we have been making it our shepherd. Brothers and sisters, and we have been so tired. We have been so tired years after years following our own desires. And there are no rest. There are no respite. You might be happy for 5 minutes. And in the next 5 minutes, when your drugs is already empty, or your drinks are already been empty, you are losing that happiness. You are losing that sense of joy. You are losing that sense of happiness that it seems like to skyrocket you to the moon in 1 minute and plunge you down into the deep bowels of the earth the next minute. You have been following that happiness that you thought that it will bring me joy, it will bring me happiness. But at the end of the day, it will bring you nothing at all. You found yourself lying in your bed and asking yourself, what have I done with my life? Why am I like this? Why everything just come and go? Why everything just come and go? Or maybe you have been enslaving yourself, toiling so much in your workplace. You work and you work and you work. And you thought all this wealth that you have been accumulated, all the richness, all the honor that people has been given you, you thought that it will make you happy. You thought that it will make you complete. But then again, you found yourself
sitting on top of the world alone with drinks in your hands and nothing else, and nothing else matter. You feel like nothing else matter, and you look upon the window, it feels like if you just jump out of this window, things would be better. Whether you are rich or you are not so fortunate, it's all the same. We are all just sheep, and we chose who can be our shepherd. But the Lord, what did he tell us, brothers and sisters? The Lord told us that he will make us lie down in green pastures, that he will lead us beside the still waters, and he will restore your soul. Brothers and sisters, the green pastures. Have you ever seen the green pastures or the still waters? There are no ends to it, from one point to another point. There are no ends to these green pastures. And still waters, it calms your soul. Brothers and sisters, what the Lord is offering to you is for him to lift up your burden, brothers and sisters. To lift up the burden that you have been accumulating in your life. You might have look at me right now and tell me, I have no burden. I feel joy. I don't believe in God. I don't believe in that ancient blindness. I don't believe in that ancient folklore, ancient stories. Those who put me in chains. But brothers and sisters, things that you have done for years and for years and for years have put you in the same chain. You thought it's the same chain, aren't you? But it's not. But the Lord will not put you in a chain. The Lord will put you to green pastures. There are no chains with the Lord. There are no chains with the Lord. He will brought you to the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yeah, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death? I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff. They comfort me. The world has been telling us that following Jesus is the same with putting ourselves in binds. And following Jesus is the same with putting ourselves in chains and slaveries. But brothers and sisters, there are no slaveries in following Jesus. We are the one who has been putting ourselves in misery. We have put ourselves in this misery because we do not know about the truth of the gospel. The truth is, the Lord loves you so much. The Lord loves you so much that 2,000 years ago, he comes to this world and he gave his life to you so that you will have an eternal life. So that you will be safe, brothers and sisters. He comes to this world so that he can lift up all the burden of your life. Brothers and sisters, do you feel heavy burden? Do you feel like your life has no meaning? And right now, if you just see outside of your window, you see the world instead of chaos. You see in America, there are a lot of things going on. In Europe, there are a lot of things going on. In Africa, there are a lot of things going on. In Asia, there are a lot of things going on. There are a lot of things going on in this world right now. And everything that we heard is bad news, bad news, bad news. But the Lord said he will put us in green pastures. He will give us peace. He will grant us peace. He will grant us peace. No chains. Peace. Peace for your soul. Peace in exchange for all those chains that you have put in your neck. All these years. All this life. Brothers and sisters, let us read the Bible again. Let us read together what Jesus said at Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. From the first 28 to the first 30. I will read it for you. Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest.
Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart. And you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. The Lord promises us rest. The world never promises you rest. The world never promises you peace in your heart. The world lies to you. The world lies to you. All the pleasures of this world that you are told would give you joy and happiness and peace in your soul. Those things have deceived you. Those things have deceived you. We have tried so much all the things that the world has given us. We have tried the drugs. We have tried the drinks. We have tried all the movies, all the pornography. We have tried to be rich. We have tried going from one continent to another continent. We have tried meditation. We have tried psychiatrists. We have tried books. We have tried everything that the world has been offering us. It gives us joy for how long? 5 minutes? An hour? 2 hours? 2 years? That's it. It's gone. And then when the well runs dry, you have to find again and find again. Brothers and sisters, the Lord is here for you today. The Lord is here for you today. And he's telling you, come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. He is willing to give you rest. He is willing to put the peace in your soul. Who can say that he is willing to give peace in your soul? Who can give peace in your soul? Who can say that he will give peace in your soul, that even when you wake up in the morning, you will instantly feel the peace of the Lord in your soul? That when you just go on about it your life, you will have the peace of the Lord in your soul? That you, if you went back to your bed, you will feel the peace of the Lord in your soul? Who in this world can give you such things? Only the Lord can. But you can only get it if you would accept him as your Lord and Savior, as your shepherd, brothers and sisters. We have all been lost, all of us. We have all wandered from one place to another place. We have been lost. We have all been in searching for the meaning in life. Some of us has already abandoned hope. We have abandoned our hope. We just thought, I would just live my life to the best I could, and then I will be dead, buried, and forgotten. Brothers and sisters, the Lord loves you so much. He doesn't want you just to be buried and forgotten. He doesn't want you to just dead, buried, and forgotten. He just doesn't want you to be empty. He doesn't want you to feel heartfulness. He doesn't want you to be depressed, brothers and sisters. He doesn't want you to be sick. He doesn't want you to be fear. He doesn't want you to be afraid. Come to him, all you who are heavy laden, and he will give you rest. He will give you rest. He will give you rest, brothers and sisters. You have tried everything, haven't you? You have tried everything in your life. Everything. Right now is the time for you to take this. There are no better time tomorrow, because tomorrow you might be gone from this world. Tomorrow, we might not know what will happen tomorrow. Who can predict tomorrow? Nobody can predict tomorrow. Brothers and sisters, maybe now this is the time for you to accept Christ. Now is the time for you to accept Christ. You have tried everything. All this happiness in your life. But right now, the Lord will give you eternal joy. Eternal peace. If you are heavy laden, brothers and sisters, if you felt lost, if you felt like there are nothing in this world that could give me joy right now, there are nothing in this world that could save me from the pandemic right now. I do not know whether I have the COVID-19 or not. I do not know whether I will die tomorrow or not. I do not know whether I will live in depression for years. And I do not know what will happen tomorrow. If you are asking so much and you do not know so much, brothers and sisters, it is time for us to come to Him, to come to Him, to come to Him and ask Him, Lord, save me, save me, save me, Lord. And He will save you and He will give you rest. So, brothers and sisters, let us all come humbly to the Lord right now. Let us all pray and ask Him to come into our life. Brothers and sisters, I do not ask for money. I do not ask for donation. The peace of the Lord is freely given to you by the Lord Himself, not by me, but by the Lord Himself. You can only but to ask Him, and He will give it to you. So let us bow our head and clench both of our hands. Let us ask the Lord to come into our life. And He will come. Trust me, brothers and sisters. Follow my prayers as I guide you to this prayer. Lord Jesus, I need you. I need you right now. I need you right now, Lord Jesus. I want you inside of me, Lord Jesus. I want to go to that still water. I want to go to that green pastures. I am heavy burden. And I am heavy burden very much. But right now, God, come inside me. Be my Savior. Be my King. Be the reason for me to live. Today, be my King. Tomorrow, be my King. Forever, be my King. And grant me peace in my life. Amen. Amen, brothers and sisters. There is one more good news, brothers and sisters. Before I close this message today, wherever you are right now, whether you are in the United States right now, or you are in France, or you are in England, or you are in Africa, in any part of Central Asia, wherever you are right now, brothers and sisters, if you have accepted Jesus as your Christ and Savior, you have been welcomed to the flock of our Lord. And together, the Lord will brought us to green pastures and to still waters. Peace of the Lord belongs to you right now. And right now, brothers and sisters, another good news, brothers and sisters. 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ came to this earth. He came to this earth with a mission to save us. To save us from our life of sin. To save us and to heal us from our sickness. You might be sick right now. You might have any kind of disease right now. You might have the flu, or you might have COVID-19. You might have cancer. You might have lameness on your leg. You might be blind, or some of your relatives might be sick. Your families, your friends, your loved ones. But brothers and sisters, today I want to tell you about Jesus Christ, the Lord of Healer. 2,000 years ago, He came to this world and what He has done for us. Isaiah chapter 53, you can open it in your Bible. Isaiah chapter 53, the fourth verse and until the seventh verse. I will read it for you. Surely, He has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteem Him stricken, smitten by God and afflicted. brothers and sisters. He has died for our sin. And he has died that by his stripes we'll be healed. As it stated on the fifth verse. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him. And by his stripes we are healed. All we, like sheep, have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted. Yet he opened not his mouth. He was led as a lamb to the slaughter. And as a sheep before its shearers is silent. So he opened not his mouth. But brothers and sisters, the Lord has died for us. And so by his stripes we are healed. Brothers and sisters, if you have received the peace of the Lord in your heart right now, this is the eternal miracle of the Lord. This is the eternal miracle of the Lord. The Lord is our healer. And today, he is willing to heal you as well. If you are sick right now, brothers and sisters, if you are sick right now, have faith, brothers and sisters, and touch any part of your body that are afflicted with any kind of sickness, COVID-19 even. Touch any part of your body. Even if you are mentally, even if your loved ones or you are mentally sick, you can also pray and the Lord will heal you. The Lord will heal you. Believe in the Lord. Believe in His miracle. There's nothing impossible for Him. You have tried everything. You have tried the doctors. You have tried the medicines. And I'm not against doctor. I'm not against science. I'm not against medicines. But if you have tried everything, and yet, still, you are afflicted. Still, you are sick. Right now is the time for you to see the eternal miracle of the Lord. You will see it before your own eyes if you would believe. You will see with your own eyes if you would believe. I do not ask for money. I don't ask for donation. And I will not personally come to your door and pray for you. It is not me who will heal you. It is the Lord who will heal you. The Lord Himself. But by your own faith, you will be healed, brothers and sisters. So let us touch any part of your body, of our body, that are afflicted. If you have COVID-19, just touch your lungs area, your chest area. Just put your hands, lay your hands on any part of your body that are afflicted. And let us pray together. I will pray right now. Lord Jesus, you are the Lord of miracles. You are the Lord of healings. And by your stripes we are healed, Lord Jesus. By your stripes we are healed. Lord, I pray, O God. Right now I pray, show your power. Show your miracles to these masses, O God. Show your miracles to all these people, Lord. Show your power and miracle, O God, so that they will see you as the one true God and Savior. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Amen, brothers and sisters. And as I pray today, brothers and sisters, you might already been healed. And if you are not healed yet, believe still and have faith. And you will be healed. You will be healed. There is nothing impossible for the Lord. If you have accept the Lord and receive His peace in your heart, believe that He will also heal you. Brothers and sisters, right now, wherever you are right now, wherever you are in part of the world right now, let us follow the guidelines that has been given by our government. If the government told you to be careful when you're outside, to wear mask or to keep your distancing, let us do that. Because our government, as the Lord stated in the Bible, is the authority that the Lord has given to us. So let us follow the guidelines, the rules, and all and everything that the government has put upon us in order for us to survive this pandemic. Brothers and sisters, but still, don't forget to pray. And also, brothers and sisters, if you still need any prayers, if you still need any prayers, or if you need any support, if you wish to talk to someone about all the problems in your life, whether you are sick and you want a healing prayer, or whether you are depressed and you need someone to talk to, you can always contact us through this number. Brothers and sisters, you can contact us. WhatsApp. You can contact us through Facebook Messenger. You can contact us through the appropriate channels been given below. We have services in English and in French as well. Si vous voulez en prier en français, vous pouvez nous contacter à ces numéros. Notre équipe parle anglais et français. Brothers and sisters, remember, Jesus loves you. Jésus t'aime. Jesus loves you so much. Jesus loves you so much, so believe in him. Crois en Jésus. Believe in him and he will save you. So today, brothers and sisters, let us have a good joy in our life. Let us be gladdened right now, because right now we belong to the Lord's flock. And we are his children. And right now, we have assurance, a blessed assurance for tomorrow. God bless you, brothers and sisters. God bless you, brothers and sisters. And God bless all the nations in the world. Dieu vous bénisse.